Praise be to Jesus. Today's Gospel and Reflection. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 4. Jesus stood up to read, and they handed him the book of the prophet Isaiah. Jesus then unrolled the scroll and found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and sight to the blind, to free the oppressed and to announce the Lord's year of mercy." Jesus preaching in Nazareth gained a good reputation, but the Jews did not accept him due to their ideology. They were so sure that they were God's people, and they utterly despised all others. They believed that God had created the Gentiles to be fuel for the fires of hell. And here was this young man preaching as if the Gentiles were specially favored by God. It was beginning to dawn upon them that there were things in this new message, the like which they had never dreamed. Jesus' manifesto emphasizes his preferential option for the poor. His coming gives good news to the afflicted, liberty to the captives, sight to the blind, freedom to the oppressed, and a year of favor from the Lord. A new way of preaching which was unheard of. They could understand things clearly, but there arose suspicion and arrogance in them, so that they rejected Jesus totally. The very reason for their fierce anger was that Jesus included the non-Jews in his strategy, and they attempted to kill him. The world seeks the Messiah who will take up all its burdens upon himself. The famous salutation of John the Baptist about Jesus is relevant for all times. "This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world," says John 1:29. It was very difficult, or rather, it is very difficult for those who consider their thought patterns and conservative ideas to accept Jesus as the Savior. When one looks for miracles and wonders only, out of curiosity or personal interest, he or she cannot encounter the Savior. Jesus came to preach and teach the same truth that his mission addresses everyone, especially the lonely, the oppressed, the afflicted. Christ brought peace and healing. He gave joy to all who lack any fruits of the Spirit. Church is to have the same mission of Christ. We all are called to become the instruments of this good news. Of course, there may be rejection, but our Lord and Savior went ahead of us, and He would give us the courage to face it. Combined with firm faith and purity of heart, let us accept the Savior who is around us and live His mission. It has to be continued till the end of the ages, as Jesus has instructed us: go out to the whole world and proclaim the good news. Amen.